Hello children, in this video we will learn what is the meaning of symmetry. Come, let's see what Sher Khan is doing. But what is this? He has just drawn half portion of the sun and there is no more space left in the paper. What do I do now? Sher Khan said sadly. Just then, he looked into the mirror lying just next to him. Magic! Magic! Sher Khan was excited. This mirror is magical. It has completed my drawing, Sher Khan thought. The very next day, he called some of his friends to see the magical mirror at his home with half-done images. Which image have you bought, Golu Panda? Sher Khan asked this to Golu Panda. I have drawn a half portion of a toffee. I felt that your mirror is magical, so when it completes my image, then I will eat it, Golu Panda said, drooling. My magical mirror will definitely complete your image, but you will not be able to eat the toffee. Understood, Fatso? Sher Khan said to Golu. Abracadabra. Now see how this image becomes complete in my magical mirror. Sher Khan said this and placed Golu's painting in front of the mirror. Wow! All the friends were shocked to see how the second part of the image is visible in the mirror. Come Appu, I will show magic with your painting. Sher Khan repeated the magical words and second part of Appu's painting is also visible in the mirror. Appu and Golu started clapping excitedly, but Bhola Donkey was quiet. Come Bhola, now it's the turn of your cup painting, said Sher Khan to Bhola and tried to take his painting, but Bhola refused. This is enough magic for one day, my friend. We will see magic with this painting later on, Bhola said to Sher Khan. Appu and Golu went home. Sher Khan asked Bhola why he did not allow him to show the magic with his painting. Because your magic will fail. You can't try it right now, Bhola said to Sher Khan and handed over the painting of his half cup to him. Sher Khan placed Bhola's painting in front of the mirror. But what is this? The second half of the cup in the mirror doesn't seem to appear. Sher Khan was surprised and asked Bhola, how did you come to know that my magic is going to fail? That is because my painting was not a symmetrical object, Bhola said to Sher Khan. Bhola started scratching his head and asked, what is a symmetry? Symmetry happens when two parts of any object are the same. This is the reason when you see one half of an object in the mirror, then you can see the other half looking exactly the same, and you feel that the picture is complete. There is no magic in your mirror. Magic actually is in symmetry. Yes, but what about the secret of my magic mirror? Sher Khan said sadly. Don't worry, your secret is safe with me. Then Bhola winked at Sher Khan and they both began to laugh. So children, in this lesson, we learnt what is meant by symmetry. In the next video, we will learn more about this with some examples. Symmetry. In the previous video, we learnt what is symmetry. Do you remember Sher Khan's magical mirror? Can you identify which of these incomplete images will become a complete image in the mirror? Good, you got it right. These are the images that will be complete in the mirror because they are made of two similar parts. And these images will not be complete in the mirror, because they are not made of two similar parts. In this video, we will learn to divide an image into two similar parts with the help of dotted lines. Sher Khan became very popular because of his magical mirror. But one day, he noticed that there's a huge crowd around Meenu in the classroom. Look, I will draw a dotted line on the image and it will divide the image into similar parts. Meenu is telling children with the image of a star in her hand. She draws a line like this on the image. Wow! This magic is better than Sher Khan's magical mirror. The children shout with excitement. Sher Khan draws a C on a paper and shouts, "If your magic is better than my magic, then can you divide the C in two similar parts with the help of a dotted line?" Meenu smiled and drew a dotted line like this on Sher Khan's C. Sher Khan is shocked. He takes Bhola to one corner of the classroom and tells him, "Bhola, you are very clever. Can you teach Meenu a lesson by proving that her magic is a failure?" "Okay, I'll help you," Bhola said to Sher Khan. Bhola draws a socks on the paper and tells Meenu, "Can you divide this image into two similar parts by using a dotted line?" Meenu thinks a lot and says, "No, I can't." Sher Khan starts laughing, looking at her, and other children feel surprised that her magic has failed. Then Bhola explains, "There is no magic. There are some alphabets and objects that are made of two similar parts. Therefore, they can be divided into two similar parts by using a dotted line. However, there are some objects and letters that are not made of two similar parts. Therefore, they cannot be divided into two similar parts by using a dotted line. Children, can you guess which among these images can be divided into two similar parts by a dotted line?" "Wow! You are smart. These are images that are being divided into two similar parts by the dotted lines. And these are not getting divided into two similar parts." Appu gets excited. "Bhola, I have made a mask of my face on this sheet. And I have also drawn this line. Can you tell me how will I come to know if this line is dividing my mask into two similar parts or not?" "This is very easy. If you want to know whether a dotted line can divide an image into two similar parts or not, then just fold the image along with the dotted line. If both parts coincide, then the line is dividing the image into two similar parts. This is the reason your line is not dividing your mask into two similar parts," Bhola said to Appu. All the children are impressed by Bhola's intelligence and promise not to call him a donkey ever again. "Come children, today I will teach you one more interesting fact. Can you tell me what are the difference between these two images of Babban?" "Yes, this is correct. Whatever you are seeing in the left image is completely opposite to the image on the right. For instance, his left hand is on his waist in the left image, but in the right image, his right hand is on the waist. In fact, If you see the image of the left hand in front of the mirror, then you can see the image on the right hand in the mirror. Such images that are similar but completely opposite of each other are called mirror images. Here are some examples of mirror images. Now try to see different objects in the mirror and enjoy learning more about them. In this video, we learned about mirror images and dividing images into two equal parts with the help of dotted lines. Hello children. Today we will learn about dot grids and learn how to create shapes using dot grids. In the last lesson, we saw how the smart Meenu saved Raju and Bablu from Gaggu the hippo and Babban the monkey. Raju and Bablu have gone to Bhola the donkey and tell him that Meenu told them that no one can make a better shape than her. They wanted to have a competition between Meenu and Bhola. They will make the same shape in the competition. Meenu first shows her shape to the competition judge, Batak Uncle.
What shape are you trying to make, Meenu? I'm not able to understand anything.
Badbula Batak Uncle asks Meenu.
Oh, this is a kite, Uncle Duck. Can't you identify it?
Then Bhola gives his shape to Batak Uncle. As soon as Meenu sees the shape, she is shocked.
Very good, Bhola. You have made a very good shape of the kite, said the Badbula Batak Uncle.
But how did you manage to make such a perfect shape?
The secret of my good shape is a dot grid, Bhola said.
Dot grid? What is that?
Dot grid, I will explain. Suppose, in your maths book, where every line meets, you make a point. It will become a dot grid. If you do not have a dot grid, you can make it by using everyday items. Just place the points next to each other and on equal distance under each other. To make it, you can use a ruler, a rubber, a matchbox, or any other small thing, Bhola said to Meenu. With some practice, I can make this dot grid almost myself.
Can you please show me how to use this dot grid?
Meenu asks. Suppose I have to make a square. Then I'll join these dots, that is points, then these two points, and then finally I will close the square in this way. Did you see? Bhola explains.
So now I can make perfect shapes.
Wait, Meenu. First I want to see that you really understand. Here are some unfinished squares and rectangles. If you can complete them, then I will teach you to make other shapes, Bhola told Meenu. Come children, you can help Meenu by completing these shapes in your notebook. Very nice. Now you can try to make flowers, boats and stars, Bhola told Meenu. Children, you can also practice making this with us. First make flowers. Now
Now make a boat. And now make stars.
Oh, this dot grid is actually very good. I really did not know that we can do this so easily.
Now do you agree that you are not the smartest?
I am intelligent.
Some people will never improve. Today we learned what the dot grid is and how to create a shape using dot grid. In the next video, we will learn to create patterns using dot grids. In the previous video, we saw that what is dot grid and how to create a shape using dot grid. In this video, we will learn more about this using some interesting examples. Minu is very sad because she could not prove that she is smartest. She went to sleep feeling very sad. In her dreams, she sees a dot grid flying. She feels as if she herself is flying in the sky over her village. Minu is very happy that she can fly. She flies into Chanda Squirrel's house. Chanda is watching TV. But what is this? Chanda cannot see her. Minu is very happy to know that she cannot be seen. She made this type of pattern on Chanda's TV. After yesterday's defeat, she starts thinking about how to make this pattern using the dot grid. What is this? She can suddenly see a dot grid behind the pattern on the TV. Minu starts jumping happily. Let's see how we can make this pattern using the dot grid. First, we will join these two dots and create a vertical line like this. Now we will draw a horizontal line from this dot. Then we will join these two dots to make a slanting line. Then we will repeat the same method for another triangle. And that's how we make our pattern using the dot grid. After this, Minu wanted to see what Golu Panda is doing. She flies off to his house and sees that he is struggling to wear trousers. There is such a pattern on his trousers. Minu laughs upon seeing Golu. It is good that he cannot see her. Minu thinks, how can she make this pattern using the dot grid? Suddenly, Minu sees a dot grid on his trousers. Minu is shocked. With the help of a dot grid, this pattern can be easily made. Minu thinks to herself. Come children, let's take a look at how Minu makes this pattern using the dot grid. First, we will create a square like this. Now we will create another square below using this corner of the first square like this. Now we can complete this pattern like this. Isn't this fun? Can you complete this beautiful pattern with the help of a dot grid? Minu was always afraid to go to Sher Khan's house, but now she thinks that Sher Khan will not be able to see her, and so she decides to go to Sher Khan's house. she goes to Sher Khan's house and sees this pattern on the door of his closet. She thinks how she can complete the second part of this pattern using the dot grid. Yes, in this way, we can complete the second part of this pattern. Now kids, this is an exciting question for you. Can you complete the second part of this pattern? Well done. You have completed it. Suddenly, Sher Khan comes from behind and shouts, "Boo!" Meenu suddenly awakens and sits up in her bed, getting scared. Meenu is relieved and she says, "Thank God that this was just a dream." In this video, we saw how different patterns can be made using a dot grid.